So it's important we understand the notation, okay? G is being a graduate, G complement is not being a high school graduate. So when you look at the table, we're only concerned with the total column at this point. We just want to know how many out of the 500 are not high school graduates. So we look at our totals. This is 190, right? Yes. 190 students are not high school graduates, and 310 are high school graduates. So when it asks for the probability of G complement, that is 190 over 500. Okay. So in our two-way table, you have the event A, and you have A complement. You have event B, and you have event B complement. Then how does that go into a Venn diagram? If we label this area 1, this area 2, this area 3, and this area 4. Okay, the numbers that are inside our two-way table go into the Venn diagram. 1 goes in the intersection, right? 1 is both A and B. That's your intersection. Area 2, I maybe have labeled these wrong, but this is A and this is B. Area 2 is B, but not A. So area 2 actually is out here. It's the people that are B, but not in the both category. Area 3 is A, but not B. And area 4 is everything that's not inside. Now your entire circle, when you add those together, are your totals. So your totals aren't what go into the Venn diagram. And it's going to be important for when we start to do conditional probabilities as well. Okay? So yesterday, we looked at the probability of being able to taco tongue or evil eyebrow. And it wasn't as simple as just adding them together. Why? It was more than the total because some people could do both, right? It added up to more than the total number of students because we have the people that can do both and they get counted twice, right? So because they're overlap, and it's that idea of they're not mutually exclusive. We talked about that vocabulary word last week. Mutually exclusive means you can have one or the other, but you can't have both. Okay. So for number 2 here, probability of being a graduate or a homeowner does not equal just adding them because those in the both category get counted twice. So you can't just add them together because they are not the events G and H are not mutually exclusive. Then it says find P of G or H. Okay, so I don't know if we got through that part, but I want you to work on 2, 3, and 4 in your group. And then I'm going to pass out the examples I have. We'll do those, and then you will have time to do your homework. Okay. So, what does it mean to be a graduate or a homeowner? Who does that all include? The people that are graduates, right? And not homeowners. The people that are graduates and homeowners. And the people that are homeowners but not graduates. Those all qualify as graduate or homeowner, right? One or the other or both. Which is why to find the probability of G or H, we can add up all the boxes except for the no-no, right? The no-no group is the only group that's not in the or category, right? So when we add that up, that's 310 plus 119 is 429 out of 500 and whatever that decimal gets you, right? So we're just adding up the yes, yes, the yes, no, and the yes, no, leaving out the no, no. Now when I draw a diagram, the both is my 221. If this is graduate, the first circle is graduate and the second circle homeowner, what goes in the graduate only are those that are graduates but not homeowners. So that's a yes to graduate, a no to homeowner. How many is that? No. Wait, what did I say? Yes to graduate, no to homeowner. 89, right? Because you may have set up your circles differently than the way I did, right? So then what's the number for yes, homeowner, but not a graduate? 119. Okay. So another way to actually find the probability of or, and 71 is the outside, everything that's not in the circles, is to add up, make the Venn diagram, and then add up these numbers. Right? That's the same thing we did here. So the Venn diagram can be a tool to help us. Then the last question is, what's the find the probability that someone is not a high school graduate and is a homeowner. So that's no to graduate and yes to homeowner. How many is that? No to graduate, yes to homeowner, 119. So that will be 119 out of 500. And you can get your decimal. Okay. Now, there is a formula that we can use to find these probabilities. Because remember, yesterday we said we had counted that both group twice. So we had to subtract that off of the total. And then we ended up with the correct answer for OR. So this is our general addition rule. And as a rule, it's better to make the Venn diagram than it is to just memorize equations, right? To understand the Venn diagram and how to draw that and how to use that to get your probabilities is more useful than just memorizing some equations. Okay, but here's the equation. The probability of A or B is the probability of A plus the probability of B. But you have to subtract off the probability of A and B because that group got counted twice. Okay. So that happy, healthy, rich, or famous. At the beginning of the year, we looked at this information. One question on the Census at School survey asked students if they would prefer to be happy, healthy, rich, or famous. Students may only choose one of these responses. The two-way table below summarizes the responses of 218 students from the United States by sex. Suppose we choose a student at random from these 218, define A as an event of a female, selecting a female, and B as selecting a student who prefers to be happy. Find the probability of B. Find the probability of someone saying, I choose happy. How many students said, I choose happy? 136, right? When you are given a single event in the probability, you are looking at the totals. Okay, so I had 136 out of how many? 218. Okay. Then the probability of B, find the probability of female and happy. So how many students said, how many female students said they want to be happy? 90. That's 90 of the female students said happy. And it's, we are selecting them from the total. So this is 90, oops, I need a marker. 90 out of how many? 218. Okay. We'll get to conditional probability tomorrow, where I say, what's the probability that a female student said they wanted to be happy? That's different than a female and happy, because you're randomly selecting someone from the whole group. What's the probability it's female and happy? Okay, so from the whole group, not from the females. Then the second one is find the probability of A or B. So what would that be? Female or happy, right? Dang it, I keep doing that. Now, could we draw a Venn diagram for this? Do we want to do that? So, female, happy. How many go in both? 90 students said both, right? So, how many females are there that did not say happy? Right? How many students that said happy were not female? That you can't see. So if I want to know the probability of female or happy, I can add 30 plus 90 plus 46 over the 218. That's 120 plus 46, 166 over 218. Right? Now I could also use the formula. Probability of female, that's 120 out of 218, plus the probability of happy, 136 out of 218, minus those that got counted twice, the both, minus 90 out of 218. Still going to give me 166 out of 218. Okay. Questions on that? That ends up being the probability of female, put that up here, plus the probability of happy, minus the probability of female and happy. I don't like how they just use A and B. On probability, we almost never just use A and B, right? We're going to use letters that make sense to us to help us figure out what we're trying to find. Second example, in one large city, 81% of all residents have a smartphone. 73% have broadband internet access at home, and 64% have both. What's the probability that a randomly selected resident has a smartphone or broadband internet access? So let's define some variables here. What's a smart variable to use for a smartphone? S. Probability of a smartphone is 0.81. right? I'm just writing down the information. What's the next event? Broadband internet. Do we want to use an I or a B? A B, okay. Broadband. What percent of residents have broadband? 0.73. Then 64% have both. That's the probability of S and B, right? That's what both means. And what percent is that? 0.64. He's not here today. Sorry. Okay, so let's make our Venn diagram. This one, I really want, this is why I want to do these examples, because this one's not giving us the same information. So if I have S and B, what's the one I definitely know? The overlap is what percent? 0.64. Okay. Now, the circle for S totals to 0.81. But remember that this number is those that have smartphone but do not have broadband internet at home. How are we going to find that? Subtract, right? If 64% have both, and 81% have a smartphone, we have to subtract the 64% to find those that only have a smartphone, right? 81 minus 64 is what? 0.17. Okay. And those that have broadband, that circle totals to 0.73. Which means what percent have broadband but not a smartphone? 0.09. Subtract 0.73 minus 0.64 is 0.09. 0.81 minus 0.64 is 0.17. Okay. Now, can I find the probability of having a smartphone or broadband? What do I add up? 0.17 plus 0.64 plus 0.09. I got 90. Questions? Okay, that's a little different from taking the data from the two-way table because it doesn't give you that value of not, it gives you the totals. Okay. And then I'm going to give you a chance to do who has pets. In one large city, 40% own a dog. So let's say the probability of a dog is 0.4. And 32% own a cat, 0.32, probability of a cat, and the probability of a dog and a cat is 18%, 0.18. So make the Venn diagram, and then find the probability that a resident owns a dog and not a cat. Probability of dog and cat. Complement, not a cat. No cat, but only a dog.